Betty Tekeranyi belongs to a pastoral community in Mukutani area of Baringo County. Mukutani is a semi-arid area inhabited by two pastoral communities, El Chamus and Pokot. The area used to experience cattle rustling with a majority of people losing their livelihoods. The county and the national governments, together with the UN and other non-state partners, came in to support the community who were already trying out farming as an alternative livelihood.
Walikuwa na hiyo general food distribution walikuwa napewa tu bila malipo yote. Thereafter walikuja kubadilisha wakapata hiyo food for asset hiyo kufanya kasi alipo wakapata hiyo portion.
Through the WFP Food for Asset program, members of the two communities worked together to cultivate and irrigate a communal farm. The government offered technical support, including field extension services. Now, community members like Betty have an alternative source of livelihood.
Hiyo mafuno tu nasidi kuongeza. Nikipata hiyo mafuno naongeza hii duka yangu. Sasa ndio hii duka yangu imeanza kunisaidia.
This is one of the many transformational interventions across the country under the United Nations Development Assistance Framework, UNDAF. UNDAF is a commitment by the United Nations to support Kenyan people in their self-articulated development aspirations. Led by the government of Kenya and supported by the UN system, the framework was signed in 2014 to run through to 2018.
The unique thing this time around with working with the UN is that they have implemented this new principle of delivery as one. But this time around, the UN agencies have come together working with the government where the government sort of drives in the driver's seat and working with these agencies with programs which are aligned to our development aspirations.
This is not about assistance, it's not about help. It's about a real partnership to advance human development and to advance economic and social development.
When Joseph Orango was charged with aggravated assault, he was unable to meet the original bail terms set by the court.
Fika kotini ndio nikawekewa, nikaambiwa pondi ya kuweza kutoka ni 1100, kasipiri ni 1050.
After being in remand for 6 months, he benefited from the new bail and bond guidelines.
Kutoka hapo paraliko wameongea, wamesema hiyo mtu hataweza kulipa yate ikiwa ni ngapi. Nikaulizwa sasa unaweza lipa ngapi, nikamwambia ile pesa naweza pata ni 10.
Many people didn't know that you can ask for bail, and some people don't know that when you've been given bail, you can even ask like a month or two later to say I'm unable to meet those terms, so that they can be reviewed.
These guidelines were formulated by a task force that collected views from around the country in a bid to streamline and reform the administration of justice, ensuring fairness and the principle of innocent till proven guilty. This is an example of an outcome under transformational governance result area 1.
Kitambo kesi hizo mimi nilikuwa tayari nimeanza kupata pesa yangu, ninatoka hapa naenda wapi? Kotini, namalizana kotini na rudi hapo.
We didn't have a specific fund in the judiciary that could be charged, and this technical support and even the actual financial support now came from UNDP and IDL.
The area of human capital development has experienced tremendous outcomes. The launch of a single registry has ushered in a new era in efficiency and service delivery in social protection programs.
The whole idea of the single registry is for us to be able as a country to have one database that provides us information on all Kenyans that are providing or have access to any social protection intervention.
Cash transfers to vulnerable groups such as older persons and those with severe disabilities will now be done in open and transparent manner.
We've got a tab for beneficiary numbers from the time we started, how the numbers have been increasing over time. We've got another one for disbursements, that is how much has been disbursed so far from the beginning and how the disbursements have been. At a glance in these disbursements, you can see how much over time has been disbursed to different beneficiaries.
The benefits of the new system that was developed with assistance from WFP are many.
We are working with the UN in this program, mainly looking at support in two areas, improving governance and also resources in terms of capacity building.
In Kilifi, the UN Population Fund and other partner agencies have helped the county hospital treat many women with fistula. An example is Jumwa Wamrima, who for 50 years suffered from fistula and aware that the condition is both preventable and treatable.
These women cannot do businesses because that's the only way to sustain themselves. You get little money and you run a business. Because of that problem, they cannot stay. And the smell brings a lot of stigma. So most of the time, these women are locked indoors.
The UN Population Fund has strengthened the capacity of Kilifi County Hospital by procuring equipment to enable it undertake fistula repair. 35 nurses and 19 community workers have been trained in community sensitization and identification of fistula patients.
UNFPA Flying Doctors and the Freedom from Fistula helped us to repair 30 patients of fistula.
In May of 2016, an HIV testing campaign was conducted in Nairobi region and it targeted motorcyclists commonly known as Boda Boda. This is a group considered high risk by the National AIDS Control Council. A total of 10,000 motorcyclists were voluntarily tested.
Watu wangeweza kwenda hospitali, yani wakuwe na ule ukarimu, wakaenda hospitali kupimwa. Lakini kwa sasa, vijana wengi wananiambia, juu wanajijua tayari, kupitia ule ushauri alipewa, sasa saa hii ako na ile umahiri wa kwenda kwa hospitali na akapimwe. So hana ile uoga, ile stigma ya HIV ilitoka kabisa.
The president of Kenya launched another initiative to fight stigma. This national campaign named Kick Out HIV Stigma aims to engage Kenyan youth through the Maisha County Football League, leveraging the power of football to mobilize young people to end HIV stigma and link them to stigma-free HIV testing, treatment, and care.
As part of the anti-stigma campaign, we've also been letting people, information workers, know about HIV, about the tribunal, and I think that helps take more information out there. And it is not just about your perception, it's actually criminal to discriminate.
Another successful outcome is the construction of classes for children in early childhood education in Siaya and Homa Bay.
We are working very closely with the county government to ensure that the delivery of early school is properly done.
The joint project by UNICEF and the county governments has seen enrollment in early childhood development classes because of the school feeding component.
We feed them in school, but the parents feed them at home. And these parents are also inhibited by the status. Those who are positive have challenges in providing food. As a government, we provide food to such families.
The people who were identified were people who were coming from slums. And you find that for a parent to have money to feed, even feeding the child at home, is a big challenge.
The United Nations Development Programme has partnered with three counties to roll out Biashara Centres, a one-stop shop that provides business development services to women, youth and persons with disabilities in micro and small enterprises. The main aim of these centres is to encourage and develop small enterprises. Beneficiaries receive training on business skills development and entrepreneurship. These are skills that increase the chances of success for small businesses. The counties that have participated in the pilot program are Marsabit, Kwale, and Taita Taveta.
Now, the Biashara Center for Taita Taveta was born out of a need. One of the biggest challenges that especially women, youth, and people living with disabilities are facing is lack of employment opportunities.
We've seen businesses coming forward, new businesses, and other businesses being expanded within the county level.
Training tulipata hapo Biashara Center ya tulifundishwa mambo ya entrepreneurship. Tukafundishwa pia mambo ya biashara na marketing. Na pia tukafundishwa pia kutengeneza kufanya vitu online. So saizi naweza place tunaweza letiwa order, naweza weka kama kwa Facebook. Alafu mwenye anako interested anatupigia simu. Anataka ile kada zenye anataka, alafu tunashona, analeta order, tunamtumania.
The matatu sector in Kenya has undergone immense transformation from the unregulated, chaotic past to a more client-focused and safe industry. It is an important sector and driver of the economy, employing thousands of people. The UN has supported the sector through trainings on labor laws and sound business management.
Labor laws affect you, embrace them. They are not just for the employees, they also protect you.
We never really had a relationship with our workers. But with the new UN agency that came to us, approached us as a SACCO to the Matatu Owners Association, we ended up embracing and learning things that we didn't know, that how to respect our workers, what their dues are, how they should operate.
The Turkana initiative is sort of a case study that UN has worked closely with the counties, given its difficult environment. It was chosen as a county to see how all these four areas can succeed, especially on transformative governance in the area of human capital development and all the four strategic areas.
Our task is to do everything we can to end the conflict and to make certain that Kenyans and Ethiopians in this region have the same opportunities as other citizens of our nations.
It's a cross-border program with Ethiopia where two governments, the heads of state of Kenya and Ethiopia, actually signed an agreement on advancing human development there. This is a part of Kenya in the Moyale-Borona area which has seen internecine conflict over years.
Kenya is no doubt transforming under UNDAF. The collaborations and partnerships between the UN, the national government and the county governments, together with other non-state actors, is having an impact on Kenyans in villages, towns and cities. What was once perceived to be impossible is now happening.
We still continue to rely on the UN in coordinating the partnerships between ourselves and the development partners. The coordination aspect that the UN brings is invaluable.